You don't need to spin another sense into a graphic pack anymore. Let me introduce you the one and only motion graphic pack for DaVinci Resolve that you need for the next 5 years, the Toco Graphics. Want to take your video editing games to the next level? You know, I create all of my video in DaVinci Resolve for the past year, and one thing that always wastes a lot of time for me is creating a motion graphic from scratch in Fusion Page. And you know, I really love those fancy titled and motion graphics, but I'm the person who believes that why do I need to spend money to a graphic pack, because I can create it all by myself, right? I was wrong. Because lately I've been playing with a graphic pack that I just got from Envato. I'll leave the link down below, which basically just blew my mind. It has everything that you need to run your social media game, and we're not talking about just 10-20 elements. In the pack, you get over 2,250 graphic elements. And not just that, they also include over 600 sound effects for you to use. What I love about this pack is that it's automatically resized to any aspect ratio of the screen. Let's say if you want to use this in some weird aspects, for example 4x5 for Instagram, it's automatically resized for you. And I want to do this review as a person who also created effects before. If you haven't watched that video yet, go check that out. After watching this video, I can tell that it is not easy to create one, at least it takes some time. And for you to have these over 2,000 motion graphics compared to the price that you get, which we will talk about later in this video, for sure it is a game changer. So let's dive in and I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so in the websites, you can get some preview of what's included in the package. But once you purchase and download that, in the package itself also include a full preview URL file, which will take you to this page as well. To install this pack, you can just go into the installer folder, and typically they will give you the normal DRFX file, right? And you need to install it manually. But for this one, they have done a really good organized, which you don't need to do any of that. So if you are a Mac user, open the .package file. And if you are a Windows user, open the .executable file. Oh, and also very important, remember to read this README file, because there are some additional fonts that require you to download as well. Otherwise, the animation won't work. You can still change the fonts later. I say this because at first it's not working for me because I didn't read it carefully. So one little trick here, read the manual. So basically you need to download this fonts archive link here. And once you've done that, in the folder you just need to install all of them. They also include sound effects for you to use along with the animation, so that you don't need to go and find it yourself. See how convenient this is. So let's open the DaVinci Resolve. Once you install all of them, they will appear in title in effects tab, and the transition effects will be in the video transition right here. They categorize into a bunch of categories as shown here. And for the extra materials like these glitch effects, you just need to import it into your media pool. And if you're planning to use the glitch effects in other projects as well, you can just import it into your power bin. To use the effects, you just need to drag and drop into your timeline. And you can do all the customization in your edit page. How simple is that? But as I remember, there are some of them that needs to adjust in Fusion Page. Things like adding image, but like 90% of the time, you can achieve it in your edit page. For example, you can change the background color as you like, and the text shown in the screen, and now the position of each one of them. By the way, if the animation is too short, you can stretch it out. It will automatically retime the effects. And if it still not fits your edit, let's say you want to fully control the timing of the effects, what you can do is to change the effects into a compound clip. And go to your inspector, and under speed change, you can speed up your animation as you want. Or if you want some part of the animation faster, you can just split the clip where the animation stops and adjust the speed of whichever part you want. You can also freeze the frame at the middle section where the animation stops so that you can fully control the timing of the effects. And you can still customize the color and the text by right-click and open in timeline. If you want all the timeline to appear in different tab here, you just need to go to this icon and select the stacked timeline. And that's basically it. It's like 90% of the effects, the title, the background, or the shape elements. You can just adjust it in the same way. Now I want to talk about some of the effects that have a placeholder that lets you add an image or logo, like this one. To add on the image, you need to navigate to the Fusion page by right-click and open in Fusion page. There will be a group node instead of a single node. You need to double-click that. Once you have all of that, then you drag the media into the media nodes and adjust the position to whatever you like. Easy, right? Then you go back to your edit page and customize the text and the timing as before. There's a bunch for you to play with, like this social media one that have a lot of social media elements. Let's say if you want to promote your Instagram account, you can do it the same as how you do it with the previous one, which is right click, open in Fusion page, add your image, position it, and back to edit page and edit the text and timing. They also include some call to action like subscribe, share, etc, etc. By the way, every graphic effects you see in this video are from this pack as well. One of my favorite effects is the callouts here. For example, this one. And let's say after you have done all the adjustment, right? And there are a couple of ways to track that. But my preferred way is to use the normal keyframe because it's the simplest way. So basically, you just need to go to the frame where you want the callouts to begin in your video. For example, right here, and just position the callouts. And just click the position keyframe in the inspector, and then open the transform icon here and move the playhead forward a couple of frames and drag the callouts accordingly. They will automatically set the keyframe for you. They also includes a lot of transition effect for you. They have this flat transition, camera transition, which is the seamless transition that you guys always wanted to do, and the overlay transition. To use the camera transition, you just need to drag it into your timeline. And all of the transition you see here, they also include sound effects to use with this transition as well. So in the extra materials folder, you can just search the sound effects that you want. For example, camera transition, right? Camera transition. And then just drag it into your timeline. And lastly, the glitch effects. Glitch effect is a bit more creative, so they include the video glitch effect file for you. And what you need to do is you drag the video file into your timeline, right? And change the composite mode in the inspector into whether add, difference, or screen. And you can stack multiple of them together to get more complex glitch. And that's it. That's the end of the demonstration of what's included in this pack. Pretty long, right? You know, you can still play along with the combination of them, like what I do here. It's literally depends on how creative you are. Now, I know that you guys gonna ask, they gave you all of this, then what's the price, right? I'll let you guess how much this is. What do you think? 200? 100? 69. You get all of this. Seriously, over 2,000 elements for just $69. Alright, let's do some calculation. The last motion effects that I built took me around 2 days to create that. So let's assume that if we need around 2 days to create one single element, we're gonna have around 15 elements in a month, which is 180 graphic elements in a year. To get over 2,000 elements, you need around 12 years. What about if we assume that we only need one day to create one single graphics? We will have 30 graphics in a month and around 360 per year. That will still take us around 6 years to get over 2000 elements. But what if we're really good in Fusion page and we need only half a day to create one? That means we will get 2 graphics per day and 60 elements per month, which is 720 elements per year. That's still gonna take us 3 years. So basically you're paying $69 for your 12 years time, or at least 3 year times, right? You know, you can graduate from the college for that same amount of time, right? And as I mentioned before, you don't ever need to spend another cent into a graphic pack anymore. And I'm pretty sure that you're gonna be overwhelmed, as I do, the first time you open the pack, for sure. And seriously, if you are interested in this pack, I'll leave the link down below. And if you are enjoying this video, remember to like and subscribe. And as always, if you have any questions or feedback, be sure to leave them down below. I'll try to answer it all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Happy grading. Bye. You know, when I create my own effects, it always crashes down my program. That's why it took me 2 days to make it. It's like 80% of the time you're dealing with the program than the effects. Just so you know, that's why.